Lesson 5. I think the last time we've been already reading this one, didn't we? Okay. So.
First, we'll start the grammar, I think. So, start the grammar.
Okay. In this lesson, we will learn the following. Bilal's book, Kitabu Bilalin. The Imam's house, Baitul Imami. In Kitabu Bilalin, the first word is the thing possessed. It is called Mudaf. The second word, Bilalin, is the possessor. It is called Mudaf Ilahi. Note that the Mudaf takes neither the definite nor the indefinite article. So it is wrong to say Kitabun Bilalin or Kitabu Bilalin.
Al Kitabu Bilalin.
El Kitabu Bilalin. The Mudaf is definite by position and does not need to the definite article. Let me check. Okay, I got it. Yes. Yeah. If you read it the first time, it's a bit complicated, but yes, I have it. The Mudaf Ilaihi is the genitive case. It can have Tanween. Genitive,
what is genitive,
we have it.
Case?
Possessive.
What is genitive case?
For example, the girl's hair or.
No.
The flowers.
Last time we learned about genitive case. In Arabic, we call it majrur. So, what is the meaning of majrur?
Like genitive is always possession.
No.
I
last time
it.
We learned that majrur is called genitive case in English, and in Arabic we call it majrur. Any word which has kasra is called majrur. Here Bilal is majrur because it has kasra at the end. Al-Imam is majrur because it has kasra. So, today we are learning that mudaf ilayhi will always be majrur. Mudaf ilayhi must have. And what is mudaf ilayhi? It is
the possessor.
The possessor must have kasra.
And he's always, like, it's always in the end, like the second word.
Yes, okay. At the end.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay, again. The Mudaf Ilai. Do you pronounce it like this? Ilai.
Ilaihi.
Ilaihi is the genitive case. It can have Tanween as it is in the first example, or al as it is in the second example. So it's either Bilalun or and Baitu Bilalin.
Okay.
Al Imamu.
Here we see Bilal has the two Dhamma. Al Imam has to add one Dhamma at the end.
Yeah.
What are the words with Dhamma are called? Are they mansub, marfu, majrur? Last time we learned this.
Yes. There was too many words
so
I didn't Bilal read before.
Bilal is marfu or majrur or mansub. What is Bilal here? It is marfu because it has Dhamma at the end. Al Imam is also marfu because it has Dhamma at its end. Okay.
Yeah, I just know Bilalun because he's male and he has to have the Tanween.
Any word which has one Dhamma or two Dhamma at the end is called marfu. Okay.
Marfu.
Try to note this.
Okay.
Let me tell you again and try to note this on the paper.
Yeah. I will rewatch this and. Okay.
Listen again. Yes. Any word which has the ma at the end, it's called marfu.
Marfu.
And
with
word,
the tanwin?
Whether it is one dhamma or whether it is two dhamma, it is called marfu. So Bilal is also marfu, Al Imam is also marfu.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Any word which has fatha at the end is called mansub. Any word which has fatha at its end is called mansub.
Okay.
Or matsu. Any word mansub. Okay. Any word which has kasra at its end is called majroor. Any
mazru.
Word.
Okay.
Mazru, which has kasra at its end is called mazru. Okay.
Mazru. Okay.
Let's start now.
Okay. Al imamu baytul imami. Si. Kitabu men, whose book? Note that men is not the genitive case because it is indeclinable. Okay. For example, it does not change to indicate its function. There are certain indeclinable nouns in Arabic which remain unchanged. Okay. Yeah.
So imam is declinable and man is indeclinable.
Okay.
So you see al imamu change into al imami, but man will always remain man. It will never change.
Okay. Ala maktabi al mudarrasi.
Maktabin mudarrasi.
Ala maktabin al mudarrasi. Maktab bil mutadassi. Note that maktabun is in the genitive case because of the preposition ala, and al mudarris is in the genitive case because it's mudaf al ilayhi. Okay.
Did you understand it?
Yeah.
Okay, so tell me why we are using kasra with maktab. It is possessed, so it should have dhamma. Why we are using
kasra? Yeah, because of the Allah, it's a preposition.
Yes.
Like fi, and then, yeah, we had this. Yeah, okay.
This on the previous point, we learned that.
So the preposition is. Yes. Sorry. Preposition is always stronger. Like.
Yes, very strong.
Okay. Uh-huh, and. What else? You said something else. And the last one is big. It stays the genitive.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, I've got it.
Positive possessor.
Nice. Okay. Yes. Very good. Tahta, under. The noun following tahta is in the genitive because it is mudaf ilayhi. Tahta. Tahtal maktabi. Tahtal maktabi. Tahtal maktabi. He? Al kitabi. Yeah. Tahtal kitabi. Tahtal kitabi. Okay. Ya is a vocative particle. Vocative particle. A noun following ya has only one dhamma. Okay, I will start from here. Ya as
ya ustadu.
Ya ustadu. Ya shaykhu. Ya bala bilalu. Not ya bilalun, etc. Okay. Yes. Many rules. The words ismun and ibnun commence with hamzatul wasl. When preceded by a word, the initial I is dropped in pronunciation.
Kasra.
Kasra. Okay. Is dropped in pronunciation. Wait, let me read it again. Okay. So it's ismu al-waladi. So I say it, right?
Yes, you pronounce kasra with ism.
Okay. Al-waladi Bilalun. Wa wal ism.
Wasmul binti. Yes.
Wasmul binti as
Amina.
Amina. Amina too.
So did you understand?
Yeah. So the name of the boy is Bilal, and the name of the girl is Amina.
So ah, it was, what ah, it's point they are trying to tell us with this sentence? Let me tell you. Ismul waladi bilalum. Ism. Here I pronounce kasra under alif. I pronounce ismu. But in the next part, when ism is followed by a vowel, I just ignored alif. Alif becomes silent. Wasmul binti.
Okay.
Wasmul binti. So whenever alif is followed by alphabet, alif becomes silent. In the start, alif is not followed by any alphabet, so I pronounced alif also. Ismul waladi. But in the next part, alif is followed by a vowel, so I make it silent. Wasmul binti.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
So alif becomes silent when it is followed by an alphabet.
Okay. Ibnul Mudarrisi Tabibun. And now it's the same. Wapnul Isma. No. Imami. Tajirun. Tajirun. Okay. So the son of the teacher is doctor, and the son of the imam is merchant.
Correct. Yeah.
Okay. The last one. Okay, it's the same. Wainabnu Hamidun. Hamidun.
Good. Wainabnu Hamidin.
Wainabnu Hamidun. Why is it the kasra in the end? Ah, even, yeah, okay, I've got it. It's the genitive.
It is possessor. Okay. Possessor
okay.
Must
yeah,
have.
Yeah, kasra. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, yes, yes.
And what is possessor card in Arabic?
Moment.
Zafilay.
Mudafilay. Yeah.
Okay. Don't hesitate in asking question, okay?
Okay.
Vocabulary.
All right. So I read. Tahta, under, beneath. Ar-Rasulu, the messenger. Al-Ibnu, the son. Al-Ammu, paternal uncle. As-Sayaratu, car. As-Sha-Sha-Re-Au, street. Huna, here. Al-Kaabatu, the Kaaba. Hunaka, there. Al-Khalu, maternal uncle. Al-Bintu, daughter, girl. Mughlaqun, closed, shut. Tabibu, at-tabibu. Doctor, the doctor. El-ismu, name, the name. El-haqibatu, at the bag. Yeah. Okay.
Next chapter is the farmers.
Okay. Second. All right. Ad-darsul khams. Khamis. Khams.
Khams.
Okay. All right. Sa'idun. Aktabu Muhammadin Heza ya yasir ya a. Heza ya yasiru.
A kitabu. A kitabu. A.
Why is it together? Okay. A kitabu Muhammedin heza ya yazir. Is it the book of Muhammad? Like, is this the book of Muhammad? O Yazir? Okay. Then Yazir says?
Yasir.
Yasir. La heza kitabu Hamidin. Alright. No, this is the book of Hamid. Saidun. Aina kitabu Muhammadin. Where is the book of Muhammad? Yasir. Huwa ala al-maktabi hunaka. Hunaka. It is on the desk there, over there. Said. Aina defteru Ammarin. Okay, I've got it. Where's the exercise book of Omar? Yasir.
You can also say notebook. Where is the notebook of Omar?
Notebook. Okay. Where's the notebook of Omar? Yasir. Huwa ala maktabi al mudarrisi. It is on the desk.
Maktabil mudarrisi.
Maktabil mudarrisi. It is on the desk of the teacher. Said, kalamu min heza ya Ali. Man heza ya Ali. Aliu. Do I have to pronounce the dhamma in the end?
It is up to you. If you want, you can pronounce. If you want, you can skip.
Okay, I skip it. So, whose pen is this? Oh, Ali. Ali. Hada kalamul mudarrisi. This is the pen of the teacher. Said. Aina haqibatul mudarrisi. Where's the back of the teacher? Ali. Hiya tahtal maktab. Maktab. So, like, after tahta, it was, what was it again? There was
kasra. Yeah,
should have kasra. Okay, so it's like hiya tahtal maktabi.
Good.
Okay. Should I continue?
It is on the playlist. Okay. Tamarin.
Yeah. Tamarin. Ajib. It doesn't have
Anil.
The
cusp.
An il issa.
Anil. Asilatal adiyata.
Asilatal ta. Can you say it again, please?
Okay, let me make it easy. Ajib anil asilatil atiyati.
Atiyati. Okay.
It means that answer about the following question. Ajib means answer. It is imperative tense, fele amar. An about asilati questions. Al atiyati following. Answer about the following questions.
Okay.
So start.
Aina kitabu Muhammadin. Where's the book of Muhammad? Kitabu Muhammadin alal maktabi.
Good. Or you can also say huwa alal maktabi. It is on the desk.
Okay. Aina kitabu Ammari. Ammarin. So, like, where is the book of Omar? Huwa Sariri, under the bed. And Ena Hakibatul Mudarisi Sin.
Mudarisi. When we have Alif Lam, we use only one.
Ah, yes, right. Okay, wait, let me color it. Only one. So, Hua. Where is it?
No. Akiba is a family word.
Yes, here. Here, al kursi.
Okay, here, kursi.
Kursi yi. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Next, we have second question. Azif il kalimat al ula ila saniya. Azif means add. Al kalima, the word. Al ula, first. Ila, two. Asaniya, the second one. Azif il kalimat al ula ila saniya. Add the first word into the second word.
Okay, I understood. So it's here, it's Hamidul and Kalemul. Okay, let's start from that side. Kalemun and Hamidun. So it's Kalemu Hamidin. Hamidin.
Hamidin.
Hamidin. And here it's okay, go on here. Miftahun and El Beitu. So it's Miftahul Beitin.
Beiti Alif Lam.
Ah, Beiti. Yeah. Here it's Beitun and Abbasun. Abbasun. But this, what's Abbas? It's the name.
Abbas name.
Sorry?
Abbas is a name.
Yeah, it's a name. Okay, I heard it already. So it's Beiti Beitu Abbasin.
Good.
And that's Dukanun and Atajiru. So it's Dukanu Dukanul Tajiri.
Dukanul Tajiri. Ta is Shamsir.
Dukanul Tajiri. Correct?
Nut. Alif Lam is silent because Ta is Haruf Shamsi.
Nut. Ah, yeah. Dukanut. Okay. Wait, Dukanut. All right. Hurfatu and Ali. So this is Hurfatu Aliin. Only Ali. And here, Beitun El Muhandisu. So this is Beitul Muhandisin. Muhandisi, only Kasara. And here, this is Defterun Saidun. So this is Defteru Saidin. Here, Ismun El Waladu. That was the rule, right? Ismul Waladi.
Yes.
Ismul Waladi.
Right.
And here, Waladi. Mm-hmm. Mindil, Mindilun, Yasirun. Mindilu, Yasirin. Kitab. Kitabun Allah without anything. It has nothing in the end, right? Allah.
Yes. Yes, it does
not have. Kitabul Allahi.
Kitabullahi.
Kitabullahi. Kamisun Omarun. So it's Kamisu Omarin. And then it's Beytun Atabibu. Bintun Atabibu. Bintul Tabibi.
Toa is right? Arufesh Shamsi. So this means Alif Naam will be silent.
Bintut Tabibi. Sarirun Khalidun. Sariru Khalidin. Miftahun Asiyaratu. Asayara. Miftahu Siyaratin. It's with Al. Miftahu Siyarati. Can you pronounce it?
Miftahu Siyarati.
Miftahu Siyarati. Sayarati. Miftahu Sayarati. All right.
Next we have questions. Can you read it?
Okay.
Read it.
Do you read it?
Okay. Ikra waktu ma'a dafti awakharil kalimati. Read and write with the correct ending. Now read the question.
The question?
Yes, question. Read the question also. Ikra.
This one. Ikra waktub ma dabti awakhiril kalimat. All right. This is hard. So it's babul madrasati.
Good.
Himarul Rajali.
Rajuli, good. Himarul Rajuli.
Himarul Rajuli. Rajuli. Beitu Hamidin.
Good.
Sayaratul Mudarisi.
Mudiri.
Mudiri. Okay, Sayaratul Mudiri. Mindilu Umarin.
Ammarin.
Ismul Talibi.
Ismut Talibi.
Yeah, Ismut Talibi. Yeah, silent al. Ismut Talibi. Baytulillahi.
Baytullahi.
Baytullahi. Fi kitabillahi. Correct? So this is man or min?
Min.
So it's minna. How was it? We had it only one time.
Min.
Okay. Min baytul mudarisi.
Harf-e jar min gives kasra to the next word.
Yes, it's a preposition. Of course. Min baytil mudarisi.
What is preposition called in Arabic? Harf-e jar.
What?
Harf-e jar. Harf-e jar.
Harf-e jar. What means jar?
Harf-e jar means preposition. Harf-e jar means preposition.
But does the word jar has a meaning?
Yes, it is used in the sense of kasra, but at the moment we'll not go in detail.
Okay.
Just basic meaning is jar means okay. preposition.
All right. Thank you. Ikra. Ah no, I didn't read the last one. So it's Allah Maktabi al Maktabil Mudiri. Ikra. Aina Baitul Mudarrisi. Huwa Baidun. Okay, where's the house of the head? What's the name?
Where the house of teacher.
Of the teacher, it's far. Al Quran. Does it have an ending?
No.
Okay, Al Quranu Kitabulillahi. Kitabullahi. Okay. Thank you. Again, Al-Kabatul-tu Baytullahi. Okay, that's very long. Muhammadun sallallahu
alayhi.
That's the thing. Yeah, I know. Muhammadu sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I don't know the correct English translation, like peace be upon him.
Yes, sallallahu alayhi wasallam means peace be upon him.
Yeah. Okay. So, did I have the endings correct?
Yes.
Muhammadu sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Wasallam Rasulullah. Rasulullah. Okay. Hajuru. What's again?
Kharajal.
What's Kharaj?
Kharaja. Kharaja is past tense. It means?
I went out. Yes, I remember. Kharaja. Do I connect it then? Kharajal.
Yes.
Okay.
Kharajal Mudarrisu.
Kharajal Mudarrisu min Ghurfatul Mudiri.
Asajar min preposition min.
Min Ghurfi. Ghurfati. Ghurfatil Mudiri. Yes, I have to take a look for the prepositions. So, Heza Beitu Hamadin Wazalika Zalika Beitu Khalidin. Ibnu Ammar. Umarin Talibun. Talibun. Wapnu. Yasir. Yasiru.
Yasirin, possessor.
Yasirin Tajirun. Okay. Baitul Mudarrisi Baidun Wabaitul Tajirin.
Baitul Tajiri.
Baitul Tajiri Qareebun. هذا مفتاح السيارة. مفتاح السيارة. أين مفتاح بيتي؟ مفتاح البيت. Yeah. And here is من بيتي أمان. So it's no preposition anymore. من بيتو ياسير. Sorry?
أنت.
أمان. Ah, it's أنت. من أنت.
يا ولد.
يا ولد. So like who are you? Oh boy,
who are you?
Okay. Oh boy, who are you? أنا ابن العباسين. وابن من هو؟ And whose son is this?
Whose son is he?
Is he? Ah, yes. Huwa ibnu Khalidin.
Huwa ibnu Khalidin.
Again, please.
Huwa ibnu Khalidin.
Ah. Huwa ibnu Khalidin. Okay. Aina Masjid Rasuli. It's Rasuli then?
Yes, Aina Masjid Rasulillahi.
Rasulin.
Rasulillahi.
Rasulillahi. Sallallahu alayhi. Lillahi. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Huwa fi al-Mat. مدينة مدينة تيم هو continues هو في المدينة المنورة. What's the last word?
منورة. هو في المدينة منورة mean illuminated.
Yes, I know نور. Okay, nice. Illuminated. Okay. Eitu Hamidin
fil
Bintu. Bintu Hamid. Bintu Hamidin fil Mudar Madrasati Wapnati.
Wabintu, we don't have any
of this. Okay. Yes. Wabintu, Muhammadin fil Jamiati. Okay. Ismul Mudaris. سعيد سعيد واسم المهندس خالد what's that what does it mean
mean uncle
yes Ammu, Ammu Talibu, Talibi, Ammu Talibi, Ghaniyun. The uncle of the student is rich.
Correct.
Is this, okay.
Correct. And Ammu is paternal uncle.
Okay. باب المسجد مفتاح
Maftuhun.
Maftuhun. Maftuhun. Wa babul maz. Maz. What's that? Madrasatu. Mughlikun.
Mughlakun.
Mughlakun. It's closed, right?
Yes.
Mughlakun.
The door of the mosque is open and the door of the school is closed.
Yeah. Khalu Hamadin Fakirun. Okay. So the khal is the maternal uncle, right?
Yes, maternal uncle, right.
Okay. Of Hamid, he's poor. Sayaratu. Sayaratu Abbasin fi Sharia. Fishari. Okay, so the car of Abbas is in the street. Okay. Ibn Man, enter. Anna Ibn al-Mudarris. See. Should I translate or go on?
It is up to you. If you want, you can translate.
Yeah, I go on. Aina el kalbi? No, el
kalbu.
Kalbu, yeah. Aina el kalbu? Huwa tahtal sayarati.
Tahtas sayarati.
Huwa tahtas sayarati. Kun jamalan jimalan.
But first, listen. On the left side of the page, you see class of Jamal. Try to watch this video before the next class, okay?
Okay. Yeah.
Did you see written this? Written with green color.
Class of
Jamal. Try to watch. Yes.
But
so try to watch this video.
Because he has so many classes, I don't know which one.
Just click on this and you will open page number 27 on PDF that I have sent you already.
Ah, okay, okay.
So on that you will open page number 27 on PDF. Then you will see this. You will just click on it and video will start automatically.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, then. Kawin. Kawin means make. Kawin, make. Jumalan, sentence. Mufidatan, meaningful, useful. Bimali, by filling. Al-faraga, the blank. Fima yali, which are following. Kawin jumalan mufidatan bimali al-faraga fima yali. Make meaningful sentences by filling the following blanks. Okay?
Okay. El Beiti Mughlakun. What is again Mughlak?
Mughlak close.
Lewis.
Close, shut.
Close, down. Yes, of course. Yeah, thank you. Close, okay. It's the door. Babul Beiti Mughlakun.
Okay.
Aina Miftahu Sayarati. Where's the key of the car? I'm not Muslim, I don't know those things. What does it mean? That's the okay. It's the
Aina miftahus sayarati.
Yeah, yeah. No, I was already at the third sentence. Okay, but I got it now. Yeah.
Okay.
So it's Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam rasulu rasulullahi.
Okay, correct.
Correct. Okay. So baitul tabibi baidun. Baitul tabibi baidun. So the house of the doctor is far. Al-Qur'anu kitabullahi. What's that? Khadijatu is the woman.
Daughter.
Bintu Hamedin. Okay. Bintu. Bintu, yeah. Oh, thank you. Anna Talibatu Tul Mudaristi.
What is the meaning of the sentence?
I'm the student of the teacher.
Correct.
But Maksur means broken.
Broken, yes.
Okay, I've got it. Kalamul talibi Maksur.
Kalamul
talibi. Yeah, kalamul talibi. Maksurun. Babul Beiti Maftahun.
Maftuhun.
Okay. Kharaja al Mudarisu. Maktab. What means office in again? It's
Maktab.
Okay, Maktabi. Min Maktabil Mudiri.
Correct.
Okay. Sahih
Tarkibat Talia. Tarkibat Talia. Correct. Sahih mean correct. Tarkibat structures. Talia following. Correct the following structures. Correct the following phrases. So there's a grammatical mistake in all of them.
So okay.
Tell me, what is the mistake taking the first one?
So it has no al, I think, in the beginning. It's just
yeah.
Kalamu okay. Talibi.
Correct.
So then it's babu sayara, and then it has no nama, but it has kasra.
Yes. Correct.
Babu. Sayarati. and this is Bintu Hamadin, and that's not Hamadun. Ar-Rasulullah. So it needs the wait. It's again without al.
Yes, correct.
Ismul Waladi. Not like instead of Fatha, it's Kasra. So it's Ibnu and not Ibnun, it's only Dhamma.
Yes.
Ibnul Mudarisi. Okay. Muhammadun. Ya Muhammad. Is it correct like this?
Correct. So they are telling you that on normal occasion it is Muhammadun. But when it is followed by Ya, it is Dhamma only. Ya Muhammadu.
Okay. Correct. Ustadun. Ya Ustadu. Okay, it's the same. Khalidun. Ya Khalidu. Waladun. Ya Waladu. That's the sentence of last time. So it's like Ikra waktub ma zabtu.
Zabti.
Zabti. I always forget. Zabti. Awakharil kalimat. Ya Ali.
Ya Ali. Ya Ali. This time we will have to read the last vowel.
Okay. Ya Aliu. Ya Abasu. Sheikhun. Ya Sheikhu. Ya Rajulu. Ya.
It is a name. Ya Sirun. Ya Sirun. It is one word.
Okay. Ya Sirun. Ya Ammadur.
Ammaru.
Ammaru. Dukturun.
Good.
Ya Dukturu.
Correct.
Okay.
We'll stop here. Do you have any question?